At this point in the commencement program, the Milwaukee School of Engineering has a great pleasure and privilege of conferring its highest testimonial upon an individual whose personal and professional life and career have been defined by extraordinary and exemplar achievements in the area of business development. Serving as Chief Executive Officer for DLSM Incorporated, distinguished and distinctive service to the World President's Organization and Chief Executive Organization, and steadfast and unwavering loyalty of Milwaukee School of Engineering, we will honor this person. Your program contains information on the career and accomplishments of this candidate, who has been duly considered by the MSOE's Committee on Honorary Doctorate Degrees. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention is directed to the onstage screen for a brief video presentation.
For the last 35 years, Scott Moon has had a passion for building two manufacturing businesses in Wisconsin with a focus on growth through innovation. As a high school student, he purchased a 1930 Ford Model A and set to work rebuilding it for daily driving. He graduated from Carnegie Mellon University with a bachelor's in management science in 1974 and received his MBA from the University of Chicago 2 years later. Moon began working at Milwaukee's Ress Manufacturing as sales manager in 1979. He became president in 1982 and embarked on a multi-year effort to reinvent the company's culture and capabilities. He partnered with MSOE and other colleges in a major effort to improve workforce skills and improve employee retention. Cross-training, open office, and work cell concepts were introduced. Investments were made to acquire new equipment and rebuild older equipment in order to expand product offerings and undertake more complex manufacturing tasks. Dedicated to making Ress an international manufacturing operation, Moon expanded the plant during the 1990s, increasing capacity and adding technological advancements. Ress expanded into automotive parts production with automated assembly and robotic welding operations for manufacturers including Ford, GM, Nissan, and Toyota. They also sought and earned international quality certifications. The company accomplished an astounding turnaround in revenue and growth, and was recognized several times as a Wisconsin Manufacturer of the Year. In 2011, Ress began partnering with electric auto manufacturer Tesla Motors. They adapted to Tesla's 24/7 supplier requirements and provided parts design assistance. Ress was selected over multiple U.S. and overseas manufacturers to supply components for the high-performance Tesla Model S. In 2012, Ress was recognized as one of Tesla's top suppliers for excellent quality performance. Today, Scott Moon is CEO of DLSM Incorporated, a holding company containing Ress Manufacturing and Condex Corporation. Located in Lomira, Wisconsin, Condex provides innovative metallurgical, engineering, and manufacturing solutions to the agricultural, construction, and commercial turf and lawn care industries. When Moon purchased the company in 1982, Ress was making blades for Condex to heat treat, grind, and market. Over the years, the company's become known for producing highly wear-resistant parts. Condex provides most of the blades used to harvest small grain in North America. Like Ress, Condex pursues a growth path through innovation. The company's designed a unique laser cladding process that was ranked as one of the world's top agricultural innovations for 2014. Scott and his wife Marjorie have two grown children and enjoy opportunities for biking around the country as a family. Recently, he's enjoyed an opportunity to work with master craftsmen to produce high-quality home improvements. And that Ford Model A you heard about at the start? Still has it, and he still drives it. It's been restored to its original finish, just as it rolled off the line in 1930. Scott Moon has served as an MSOE Regent since 1993. For his leadership, dedication to manufacturing excellence, and longtime support of MSOE, today the MSOE community joins in saluting Scott Moon.
Regent Emeritus Jack Blank and Dr. Steve Bialik, please escort to the podium Scott W. Moon. Regent Chairman Emeritus John Mellows, ladies and gentlemen, on the recommendations of the Committee of Honorary Degrees, Scott W. Moon is presented to you as a candidate for the honorary degree, Doctorate of Business Economics.
President Veats, in recognition of his extraordinary dedication, application, and advancement in business and economics, in particular, testimony to his singular experience, expertise, and career-long professional accomplishments as an acknowledged leader in the practice of executive and presidential leadership. And finally, in deepest gratitude and appreciation for the constant loyalty and most generous support for the educational mission of the Milwaukee School of Engineering, it is my pleasure to present Scott W. Moon to you as a candidate for the degree of Doctor of Business and Economics, honoris causa.
By reason of the testimony contained in the citations and recommendations we have just heard, with the authority invested in the office, in my office by the Board of Regents under charter granted to the Milwaukee School of Engineering by the State of Wisconsin, I hereby confer on you, Scott Moon, as presented by Vice President Berry and Regent Chairman Emeritus Mellows, the degree Doctor of Business and Economics, honoris causa, together with all its honors, rights, and privileges. And let me say, it's a personal pleasure. Congratulations on this auspicious occasion.
Very good.
So, let me present Dr. Scott Moon.
Thank you. First, let me say that before we get into whatever I'm going to say, that it's been a really long road for the students graduating today, their family and their friends. Let's all have one more applause for all of them. So, I generally like to keep a low profile. I don't really like doing this type of thing, but quite frankly, it's an humbling experience to be in front of you all today to make this presentation. I was looking for some outs, and so I went to Kent Peterson, who produced that video, and I said, can't you just make a full-length feature? We can all sit down and watch it. I won't have to talk, and I'll even bring popcorn. He didn't want to do that. Then I went over to Frank Habib, and I asked him what he thought I should say, and he laid out this tremendous speech. It was fantastic. I was spellbound. I said, Frank, if you would give some of those same words on my behalf, I think you'd do an outstanding job. He said he wouldn't do it. So at that point, the week was ending. I was rapidly running out of options. I felt strange, you know, that feeling you get when you're about to take a big exam that you're not sure you're really ready for. Anyway, with all of my friends abandoning me, I decided I'd have to give it a go. So I'm going to talk about one of our customers today. I think the things that that have made us successful with this customer could have meaning for you as you leave MSOE and go out into the world. The customer I want to talk about is Tesla Motors. Their production started in 2006 with the Tesla Roadster. Surprisingly, this Roadster used an AC motor that descended directly from Nikola Tesla's original 1882 design. Tesla Motors is the first significant new American car company started in the last 60 years. It's the first company in the U.S. to manufacture and sell their car directly to the end customer over the internet without a dealer. They offer the customer a cost-free charging solution. And this week, they just announced they will build a gigafactory for battery production that could become the world's low-cost producer in energy storage. By August of last year nationally, Tesla's Model S sales exceeded the total combined sales of the Lexus LS, the Audi 8, and the Porsche Panamera. So why am I talking to you about Tesla? Because this company is interconnected, instantaneous, and global. Because they're using a disruptive business model to change the world as we know it. And I believe they're moving us into the future. Because hearing about our experience as a supplier to Tesla may help you think more about how you will prosper as you journey into the future. What are the things that matter most when working with a company like this? I've got four things that I kind of condensed this down to. The first one is be prepared to change your thinking. The second is that values really matter. The third is that persistence and scrappiness are key. And the fourth is that you must take on risk. So let's talk about the first one. Be prepared to change your thinking. Rest Manufacturing, that you saw in the video, is an automotive supplier to Toyota, GM, Ford. We knew that quality systems had to be in place. We knew on-time delivery had to reach 100%. We knew the main focus was cost reduction and zero defects. But we didn't really know what Tesla wanted, and we had to change our thinking. Tesla wanted a supplier that could compress time to market. This was not what our typical automotive customers wanted, but Tesla's goal is to reduce the time it takes to develop a new vehicle platform by 50%. Tesla expected rapid response. We thought a routine 1 to 2 day response would be good enough, but the desire at Tesla was for immediate response on almost a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week time frame. Tesla wanted us to provide manufacturing competencies that were beyond what we were telling them we could do. We knew that we were a high-volume production shop that focused on zero defects, high levels of automation, and ongoing cost reduction efforts. But Tesla wanted us to become a seamless supplier who could scale from prototype to mass production at a very rapid rate, depending on market conditions. We absolutely could not become a bottleneck for them. So what's the lesson here? I think this is the lesson. To succeed in this new world of ours, you've got to be willing to re-examine your thinking and your assumptions, because the current thinking and the current assumptions may be wrong for the future that you're going into. The second point is that values really do matter. At first blush, values seem like a non-issue in business. It's so personal, it's so hard to get your head around. When I got out of college, I really didn't give it much thought. Today, I give it a lot more thought. And now, I think it's a really big deal. Think about the values your parents, your grandparents, and others have impacted on you. How you treat people and foster mutual trust and respect. A culture of mutual trust and respect is one we strive for in our business. And this culture is the same one that we see at Tesla. Russ has tried to give Tesla truthful answers, even if uncomfortable. And this has built trust, which has created opportunities. The values are the glue that holds everything together. They are the thing that allowed us to meet Tesla's needs. There was no way to meet Tesla's expectations and stay within our normal operating systems. The number of parts that they were putting our way was beyond anything we had ever seen before. We had to develop simpler systems that didn't delay their deliveries. We had to trust the people using these ad hoc systems. Once we got the production flowing to Tesla, we could circle back and get our normal operating systems working. But on the startup, the beliefs and values within REST enabled us to use these ad hoc systems. There is no way we would have done it without that. The values keep people from going into meltdown during a startup like Tesla. Our manufacturing manager, who actually is a former graduate of MSOE in mechanical engineering and sat in a chair like this during his graduation ceremony, had really created and maintained the right culture for success through his sensitivity, his words, and his actions. He kept the right beliefs and values within the company during difficult times. One example of this was the time that our key manufacturing and engineer that was handling all the bills of material found out in the middle of the startup that he had advanced prostate cancer. Of course, this was a real blow to him at a time when he was under tremendous pressure with the demands of Tesla. But everyone rallied to support this person, and the manufacturing manager, they all supported this person, and the manufacturing manager was very sensitive in the way in which he worked through these problems with the engineer. Tesla never saw the problem, and today I'm happy to report that that engineer has received a clean bill of health. So many companies have a beliefs and values statement, but to be honest, until you're under real pressure, it's easy to forget how important these beliefs and values are. The next point is persistence and scrappiness. Nothing really good comes to people in this world without a lot of hard work. You're all a testament to that as you are here today after a very difficult educational challenge. I'm sure you can relate to the value of persistence and hard work. We called on Tesla for 9 months and we quoted over 100 jobs before we got our first order. We had to take the time to understand what Tesla wanted before we started to get the work from them. As one of our engineers said, Tesla wants us to break past the automotive cycle mode. Tesla wants suppliers who can keep up with them. The business model is fast, scrappy, agile, and immediately responsive. They call it an iPad cycle mentality. They have a need for electronic industry speed. Often when we see a formal presentation or a view or a documentary on a business, everything's cleaned up, kind of like in that video. It's as if it happened in a simple, neat, and effortless fashion. We don't always see the persistence, the scrappiness that goes into making that final result. Final point is that you've got to take on risk in your life. I believe that we're moving into a new world, and there will be a lot more uncertainty, not less uncertainty. You must take on risk to move forward, and you must know how to manage that risk. And I would encourage you to think about this on a personal level as well as on a business level. There was risk to going down the path with Tesla Motors. A decision had to be made at each new increment of business: how much further do we go with this company? When we started doing work for Tesla Motors in 2012, some of the experts were saying Tesla could change the face of the automotive industry. But other experts were saying Tesla could be bankrupt in 6 months. My job was to assess the risk and make decisions relative to Tesla. I started visiting their stores in California. I believe risk is best viewed with primary information, going to the place where the action is. The action was in their stores. At first, I saw and heard about numerous problems. But after about 6 months, the problems seemed to be getting under control. Then I found out that the total store visits per month on a global basis was high and growing. At that point, we committed fully to Tesla, and we haven't had any regrets. The point is that you have to deal with risk in your life, and you have to measure risk by going to the point where you can really tell what's going on, rather than relying on information that everybody else has. So to summarize, be prepared in your life to change your thinking. The values really matter. Persistence and scrappiness are key. And you must take on risk. I wish you Godspeed and best wishes as you graduate today and enter the next chapter of your life. Thank you.